Hi everybody, today is April 18th, 2013. Thanks to one of my subscribers, they sent me a link to this page. It's about the special forces that were in Boston at the time, and I reported how they were doing drills, supposedly. They had bomb-sniffing dogs there, guys on the rooftops. Now we got this explosion in Texas. I don't know how many of you know about or remember the online petition that Texas wanted to withdraw from the Union. And I guess Texas asked for their gold. They didn't want their gold to be kept in the reserve anymore. They wanted to return to Texas. There's so many secret groups and fractions within fractions. It's like layers of an onion. The Saudi Arabian student who was supposedly under police guard in the hospital. Now I heard, I don't know if this is true, but he was deported or going to be deported with no charges applied to him. But yet he was here on a student visa. Now the United States has used Saudi Arabia before for terrorist activity. They've used their citizens to get other people to do terrorist attacks, etc. So this article here about special forces in Boston. Now if you look at his hat, he's got the special forces insignia, and they have a close-up of it. They both have desert military boots, identical pants, and unless they went shopping together, what are the chances that they'd have the same clothing, right? Now they have three things circled here on these two guys. One is the insignia and the other tags on the backpacks. Originally the government was trying to say that these two guys were the terrorists responsible for the bombings. And I didn't buy it. I figured they had military written all over them. These two men seen at the Boston Marathon finish line just prior to the blast were wearing military desert boots, top picture. One wearing a cap with a logo used by U.S. Special Forces or former Special Forces. The cap reportedly is from Kraft International, a mercenary training company set up by former Navy SEAL Chris Kyle. At least one of them is wearing an earpiece, the type the Secret Service used to communicate on-site during operations. And that would be that fellow. The way his hand is cupped, it's not a cell phone. It looks like he's placing something in his ear to me. So here's a larger image. They blew it up, and you can definitely see this is definitely that icon. Navy SEALs spotted at Boston Marathon wearing suspicious backpacks. And they have an image here of Navy SEAL Kyle with his hat insignia. A National Guard crisis team, the New York-based 24th National Guard Weapons of Mass Destruction Civil Support Team, was in Boston when the bombs went off. This here, it says, the boy that died from the bomb. Anonymous writes, the two guys spotted on the finish line are from the 1st Unit, Weapons of Mass Destruction, CST, located in Boston, Massachusetts. CST standing for Civil Support Team. Now, I've seen an image of this person. I thought it was kind of odd that they would stand off in a corner of a doorway, fumbling with something in their bag. This is location 666 Street, near the oldest Masonic Tavern. Now here this man is standing, he has his backpack. Larger images I've seen, there was something that looked like a cell phone type object next to the water container in the outside pocket. And you can see here, it's the same people. This is a back view, but you got a good side view of this fellow, which is him. Here they are again. This time he's got his sunglasses on top of his hat, but there's no backpack. Interesting too, all three of these people must have shopped together. They got the same desert boots, the same cargo type pants. And then it goes on about how it's a Kraft International that was at the Boston Marathon. It's kind of like a Blackwater operation group, I should say. Here it shows after the bombing. After the bombing. More pictures after the bombing. And then supposedly this woman was at the Sandy Hook and she was also at Boston. And there's some links to some other photos. Here's the fellow there looking towards the direction where the explosion probably would take place. It says possible detonator. And then it says the team gathering after the after the blast. So we got six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 there. Here's another image of him running, it says, from the crime scene, showing that same item in his hand. What is Kraft International Private Military Force doing at the Boston Marathon? And then, interestingly, on Debunkophiles, they're saying here that there was a Saudi terror cell, possibly Al-Qaeda linked. Evidently, the fellow was from a prominent family, the one that was in the hospital, it sounds like. I'd like to remind you, in case anybody don't remember, that when 9/11 happened and all the airplanes were grounded, there was one plane that was allowed to leave. It was a private jet by one of these well-to-do, wealthy Saudi families, some oil big company. Like I said, there's so many different covert operations, groups within groups who have no idea what the other groups are doing. They have their own special agenda. It's like an onion with layers upon layers and layers. So I guess now they have another group of people that are of interest that they've released today images of. We call them Suspect 1 and Suspect 2. And they have a video here from some security camera. There's the one guy. And they'll show it from the other direction. There it is. There's the one fellow. And then the other. Just like 9/11, just like John F. Kennedy's shooting, killing. I don't think we'll ever know the truth. They're going to throw all these different scenarios out. And whichever one the public goes for the most, that's what's going to be the answer, right? All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep you up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.